Hazards of leaving your plants outdoors during the warm weather is wildlife, and something has come along and chewed up my Haworthia. It ate quite a bit of it, so I'm really not sure what it was. We do have squirrels and chipmunks and foxes and birds, but this was up in the greenhouse on a lower shelf, and something got to it. It doesn't look like bug damage, it looks more like a larger animal. But when I went to go take it out to see if part of it could be saved, I did also notice that the roots look horrible. So they're horribly dry. I think we're moving into actually a growing season for Haworthia. So what I might do is remove the damaged parts and try to replant a couple of plants here that were not chewed up. I may hang on to a couple more, stick them in water, and see if some new growth comes out. But if it doesn't look very good, or if it doesn't come back, there's probably no point in saving it. But I know I have at least two good areas here. So I'm just going to start pulling this apart, see what we've gotten here. The whole thing looks pretty horrible, I must say. All right, so I feel like this would be an okay plant to save for sure. And if I put it in a little bit of water, it's gonna fill out on the roots. And this one also has a little bit of a root and looks pretty good on the top, so I feel like pretty positive about that one might survive. This is a little baby I can put in as well. And let's see over here. These, I might just stick them in water and we'll see what happens. But honestly, some of it is, this is really chewed down. I probably won't do anything with that. I'm going to see how these do. I will put them all in water and we'll see what happens with those. But for sure, I have three small ones that I can plant in a smaller pot. And I'll just kind of have to start over here with my Haworthia clump. So that's always a shame when that happens, but you know, maybe it's a blessing in disguise because these roots are looking pretty weak. So obviously they need a little bit of therapy, and I think I'll wait a day just because I broke these off. And once that heals over, I will keep them in water for maybe about a month and see how the roots come along. So there you go, guys. The first part to trying to save my Haworthia plant. Somebody had a really good meal out of it. But thanks so much for watching. And if you haven't already done so, please subscribe. Bye.